So what next? Acts chapter 9. This is an awesome chapter. So here's what happened, okay? So remember, Stephen got stoned, and there was a man named Saul who was there approving of what had happened. He was holding the jackets of everyone who murdered Stephen right there in that place. And then he becomes the spearhead of this movement to persecute the church, to go after these believers. It's easy for us, right, looking back on this, to vilify Saul, to look at him and be like, man, what a bad guy, what an evil guy. But here's the thing, Saul was not bad, he wasn't evil, he was passionate and zealous, and he loved the Lord from the very beginning. In fact, he was so passionate and so zealous that what he saw was a cult coming against everything that he knew and everything he believed in. He was gonna go at with everything he had. He was gonna come against them and fight them and battle them, and this is what Saul does. So the beginning of chapter 9 says he was breathing out murderous threats against the Lord's disciples and went to the high priest for letters, for legal documents to say that he could go after the Christians, he could arrest them, and if necessary, could murder them himself. So he begins to pursue Christians. Now Christians have been scattered, right? So he begins to pursue them to now Damascus. Damascus, for those who don't know, is in Samaria. Remember, Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria. So he's pursuing them into Samaria, and he has this incredible vision of Jesus. Jesus says, why do you persecute me? Saul goes blind. The people around him hear the vision, but they don't see what's happening. Only Saul sees it. And so Saul stays blind for 3 days. God tells a man named Ananias to go to Saul. He says, go, because this man is going to be my vessel. I'm going to use him. Bring my message. Here's the crazy thing. So the guy who's responsible for the scattering, now he's going to be scattered. He fully gives himself to the Lord. The scales fall off his eyes. He sees clearly for the first time in his life. Only now, what happens? See, what we don't see is that he literally disappears for several years before he shows up again later in the book. Because now he has to figure out everything, because everything he knew just got flipped upside down. But here's what happens. This guy, he was responsible for scattering the church, and now he's gonna go scatter the church. He becomes one of the most powerful missionaries in all of history. In fact, I think most of us now could probably trace our spiritual lineage to him in some way. What next? Well, even at our worst, God uses us to do great things for him. What's he gonna do through you?